Hi children, welcome back. Nice to meet you again. Today we are going to see a very interesting topic in 10th standard, transportation in plants. What is mean by transport? A transport means to carry the substances from one place to another place. We call the word is transport in biologically. Before going to this, if you have to take the plants, all the multicellular organisms, their body is made up of many millions of cells. In this case, we want to carry the what we say any substances, that is energy is need. Now that energy is get it from where, means is a food material. Every cells need the what we say mainly for that is called the what is food material. Constant supply of energy is needed. That food substances are mainly to oxidizing, break down and releasing the what we say energy. That energy is need for maintains the life and survival of the what we say living being. In this case, the food is a very important source. They provide the what we say energy and break down the what we say the glucose is a breakdown and release the what energy. That the energy is need for various work to utilize the what we say energy for govern the various vital activities of the life in a plants. Now that is a very miracle. If you have to see the how that please water and nutrients are transported to top of the plant. In a leaves, the plants are prepared the food material. That food is transported to supply to all parts of the plant body. Now in this case, that is there is no any transport what circulatory systems are not seen in the plants. But in case the specialized systems are there in the plants, they are called the what is a xylem and phloem, or collectively we call the what is vascular tissues. These vascular tissues, among this vascular tissue, the water and minerals are always to absorb from the soil or transported to all parts of the plant through a vessel is called the what is xylem. The next is food. Actually where the food is prepared in a leaves, that is a leaves are called the what is kitchen house of the plant. The leaves prepare the food material. That food is transported to all parts of the plant through a system. That vessels are called the what is phloem. A phloem vessels to transport the what means a food all parts of the plant body. Now when the food materials are prepared in the bulky amount, the bulk movement of the food substances are travel or move from one part of the body to another part of the body through a vascular tissue. A bulk movement we call the what is from the leaves to all parts of the plant body, we call it as a translocation. That is we call the what is translocation. Now we go for the what means next. What is means of the what means a transport in plants? Transport means is nothing but carrying the things from one place to another place. In larger organisms mainly there is no any circulatory system is not seen in the what means a plant, but in case of the higher organisms in the animals, it has a what means circulatory system. The circulatory system is a consists of a pot, that is a central pumping organ is called heart, and blood vessels, artery, veins and capillaries, then transporting a fluid we call the what is blood. In case here, that is called the transport of materials in and out of the cells. We take the what means any one cell, there are some materials are enters in and some will be say going out. The transport of any material inside, go inside and come out of the what means a cell, carried by a simple we call the what is diffusion, spreading wherever, and active transport. Active transport is the very important. Active means is a we will be study later on. Next, now diffusion. What is mean by diffusion? In case of the what means a the movement of any molecule, the movement of molecule in liquid and a solid from a region of higher concentration to region of lower concentration without utilize the what means any energy until the what means uniform distribution, we call the word is diffusion. Tamilla we call the word is viral allathu paraval. So that is called the word is diffusion. So that is, we take the bulk bucket of water, we add the, what means, two or three drops of the, what means, liquid blue. After some time, that is the entire bucket of water becomes the blue in color. This is an example for diffusion. Or we take the, what means, burning of the incense sticks and keep it in the any corner of the room. The entire room is get fragments. That is called diffusion. Now that is before the, what means, diffusion. After the diffusion will be spreading into evenly to all. This is called the word is diffusion. Mainly we call the word is diffusion. Next we go for active transport. Active transport is there, utilize the energy to pump, the molecule against the concentration gradient. What is mean by against the concentration gradient? Higher to lower is a concentration gradient. Against means opposite. Up now lower to higher. A movement of any molecule from the region of lower concentration to higher concentration. Here expenditure of energy is very important. Using of the, what means, energy. Now the active transport is carried out by means of a membrane bounded protein. Now we take the, what means, membrane. This is a membrane. The membranes are bounding the, what means, some protein molecules. These protein molecules are a very important role for to move the or allow the, what means, amount low concentration to higher concentration. The transport of the substances from lower concentration to higher concentration. From lower to higher means that is we call the word is uphill transport. This is also called the word is uphill transport. Next, osmosis. What is mean by osmosis? That is osmo means is a water. The movement of water molecule through a semi-permeable membrane. Now, the movement of solvent or otherwise is a water molecule from the region of higher concentration to region of lower concentration through a semi-permeable membrane. Otherwise, we call the word is partial permeable membrane. Partial permeable membrane. This process is carried out till we get the, what means, equilibrium. That is called balance. Balance is reached until that is called osmosis will be happened. Osmosis is the water's movement of water molecule from the region of higher concentration to lower concentration through a semi-permeable membrane. So next we see the, what means, plasmolysis. What is mean by plasmolysis? The plasmolysis is when the waters are move out from the, what means, cell. As the result of the, what means, waters are coming out, the cell is become the, what means, shrinking. That is a shrinkage of the cell membrane away from the cell wall. Away from the, what means, cell wall. That we call the word is plasmolysis. As the plasmolysis, before the plasmolysis, the cell is entirely gets full water. After the water is removed, the cell become the, what means, completely swelling. It become the, what means, shrinkage. So that is waters are removed means the plasmolysed plant cells. Plasmolysed plant cells. The next way we go for the, what means, next part. Inhibition. What is mean by inhibition? Now we have to take the inhibition is there nothing but we call the word is a type of diffusion in which a solid absorbs a solid to absorb the water and then get a, what means, swelled up. Now we take the, what means, resin. Dry grapes putting into the water. After the next day we have to go and observe. We see the, what means, swelling. This is an example for absorption of the dry absorption of the water in dry grapes and then absorption of the, what means, water by the seed. If you are to putting the seed into the soil, they are swelling, swell up, and a young plant will be coming out. If there is no any, if there are no any inhibition, seedling would not have been able to emerge out of the, what means, soil. There is no any emerge out of the soil. Inhibition is very important. Next we go for the, what means, root hair. Now we have to pluck the, what means, any one of the plant. Now that is many millions of root hairs are found. This is a root hairs. This root hairs are a absorption unit. The root hairs are very thin, slender, lateral, outgrowth are comes from extension from the epidermal cells. This is we call the word is root hairs. The root hairs are to increase the entire surface to absorption of the, what means, is water. The absorption to increase the area of the absorption. increase the area of the absorption. Next we go for how that is a the pathway of the water absorbed by the root. How that is a water is absorbed. The waters are generally outside. That means is a more water is there in the outside. The water will be enters into the what means here root hair cells. Here more concentration of the water molecules are a more concentration of the waters are a in a root hair cells than the what means a root a AP that is called a cortex cells. That is a cortex cells. Now that is a reason. Now that is a water sorry always to move from the region of the higher to lower from the root hair cells enters into the waters or enters into the cortex cells. Cortex cells from the cortex cells the water is enters into the what means here upward movement of the vessels. That is we call the what is xylem. Xylem vessels. This is a pathway. The waters are always to move into the what means through the xylem enters into the where. All parts of the body. That is called stem and leaves of the plant body. So that is called pathway. Waters are enter from the air, root hairs to into the what means here cortical cells by the process is called osmosis. Osmosis is nothing. We know that that is a movement of water molecule from the region of higher concentration to lower concentration through a semi permeable membrane. Next we go for the types of movement of water in the root cells. That is once the waters are absorbed by the root hairs, mainly it can move deeper into the what means here root layer. Two distinct pathway. There are two important pathways. One is called the what is apoplastic pathway. That is apoplast pathway. Apoplast. What is mean by apoplast? You see the here that is a diagram. That is a green color structure. Apo means is nothing but the movement of waters are occurs through the what means intercellular spaces found between the walls of the cells. They are mainly depend on the what means a gradient. That is called a water gradient level. Apoplastic pathway. While in case of the symplastic pathway means this is we see the what means a blue color is indicating the line indicate the what means a symplast. In this case that is in this movement the waters are always is a travel through the what means is a yes cells. That is it has a what means is a so their cytoplasm between the cells it has a what means a very minute gap. Intercellular movement is a occurs through the cell membrane. It has a what means small minute opening that we call the what is plasma desmata. Now the movement of waters is a relatively is very slow. Now the waters are moving that is called against down the water gradient. That is against down it is a go back that is called a come back. Now the water is going to that side means again it will be come down. It is a through narrow crevices that is called the what is plasma desmata present in the cell membrane. Next we go for the transpiration. What is the transpiration in our kitchen? That is after use of the coriander leaves putting into the cover and put it there down in the any corner. Next day we have to go and see a small water drops is found in the what means is that polythene cover. That is nothing but is a transpiration is one of the necessary evil. That is a plants are a the evaporation of the waters in a plants through the what means a stomata that we call the what is necessary evil is called the what is yes stomata transpiration. Adukku we call the what is transpiration. Stomata is open in a day time and closed in the night time. That stomata when the stomata is open and closing is mainly depends upon the turgidity of the what means a gut cells. Now when the waters are enters into the what means a gut cells that is they become the what means turgid. They become the what means turgid and leads to open the what means a stomata. That is a stoma will be open between the two gut cells. That is called a, now this is a gap. This gap we call the what is stoma. This stoma will be open. Now when the gut cells are lose the water that time where the waters are lose it mean the it become the gut cells are become the what means a placid. Now there is no any gap. They are placid. So that is a placid mean the stoma that is a stoma will be closed. The stoma will be closed. In this case when the leaves that is a mesophyll cells. From the mesophyll cells, the water will be say lost. When the water is a lost, mean that waters are absorbed from the veins contain the what means that is a middle, that is a veins. The veins are a from the veins to absorb the what means a water, absorb the water by the process is called osmosis. By the process is called osmosis. Now, when the more waters are evaporated, when the waters are evaporated in the mesophyll region of the leaves, from that is a xylem to absorb the what means a more water from the what that is called xylem part. Now, if the top of the plant to increase the what means a some pressure is increased to pull it up the what means a certain water. That way pull is called the what is transpirational pull. Transpiration pull to absorb the what means a more water from the soil. More water from the soil. It leads to reach the waters of the topmost part of the tall plant. Topmost part of the tall plant. Next we go for the transpiration. Now the transpiration is here, that is a guard cells, the opening between the two guard cells, it has a what means a gap is called a stroma. We call that stroma. Now the stroma will be closed. The guard cells are become the swollen and guard cells become the what means a shrunken. The guard cells in the turgid and placid condition. Placid conditions. Next we go for the importance. Before going to this is a transpiration. Now the transpiration is affected by the two important factors, that is a internal factors as well as the what means external factors. What are the external factors? Mean depend upon the intensity of the what means a sunlight, that is called a temperature, that is a wind, humidity, that is a moisture content, humidity etc. What are the internal factors to affect the transpiration? That internal factors are a canopy structure. What is mean by canopy structure? Means the whole integrated structure of the stomata. The next is the distribution of the stomata in the leaves. And then the stomatas are a distribution of the stomata in the leaves. And then is a water, that is a water content of the what means a water level. Water level of the what means is a leaves. Water levels of the leaves. These are internal factors to affect the transpiration. Now the importance, what are the significance of the transpiration? That is a transpiration is a very important part to create that transpirational pull through transport of the what means is a water, to absorb the water. This is a main thing for to supply the what means a mainly photosynthesis, supply the water for photosynthesis, transport the what means a most of the minerals and what important minerals and the nutrients are absorbed from the soil and enters into the all parts of the plant body. And then we have to keep the areas are very cool and surface, that is a cool the surface of the leaves and the evaporation by means of evaporation. And keep the cells are very turgid and maintain the what means a shape and maintain the shape. These are the main importance of the what means a transpiration.